Hey, how you doing? Gonna show a little bit of the peripherals today, probably like some gun and controllers, but yeah, so this is like my main menu, arcade, consoles, collections, handhelds, PC games, pinball, peripherals, MISC stuff, and generation system. So if I sit over here, I go to the arcade section here. Let that load up. And of course, I've got my main stuff, four-player main stuff, some clones, adult stuff, kid stuff, HB main, misfit main. These are all your hacks and stuff like that. Your Pac main, which is all Pac-Man based stuff. Ring Edge, which are all my Ring Edge stuff, and then these are going into like the classic, the categories, like Nintendo, Sega, Namco, SNK, Capcom. I'm not gonna go down all of it, but for the most part, I've got like a nice animated marquee for everything, as well as, you know, all the setup and stuff. So let me, all the way down to your shmups and stuff like that. Naomi stuff. And everything is, got a nice theme to it and color. Tater Type X. Dragon's Lair stuff. Like I said, this is all your arcade stuff, so we're gonna have to Ring Edge here and stuff like that, because we're gonna go through some peripherals and stuff. And let me try a gun game here. Transformer. So I'm gonna pause this while this is loading, so nobody's waiting forever. All right. This is your, this is a name track. I've got two of them. The name track works pretty well considering. And I mean, considering their aim tracks, so they're pretty pretty quick. But I mean, I'm hopefully getting some of those new Sinden light guns that are coming in. Those are supposed to be really quick. I talked to the creator and stuff like that, so I'm pretty excited to get a hold of those. Maybe do a review on them and stuff. But I mean, these do pretty well considering. But of course, you know, I'd rather not have the reticles. I'd rather be able to aim and have it hit. I've had a few issues with the aim tracks. But for all in all, they tend to work pretty well. Let me X out of here. Back up to memory. So this is basically all your arcade stuff. Aim tracks work pretty well with most of it. Then you get into like consoles and stuff. So let me back out here a little bit so you guys can see the cool themes. You can back out to the main menu. Turn the volume up a little bit. So a really cool thing about this is whatever you're in, it'll tell you what type of menu you're in. So say I'm in here with game consoles. If I switch this to arcades, it'll switch the little light to arcades, and basically it'll stay on there and tell me what category I'm in. So if I go to game collections or handhelds, it'll light that up specifically for that. I got some nice themes for this as well. So mostly I have marquees for basically every game that's been released for all these systems. So if I go into Super NES here, you'll notice that a marquee will come up for something. Wolverine, Wolfenstein, Wordress. So yeah, and you get a marquee for anything, and this is all like the old Super Nintendo box art and stuff like that. The same thing with most of the other stuff. So I guess that's CD and stuff. I'm not sure if it gives you a box out for that. So your Nintendo, your hacked Nintendo, 3D NES, nice and... I try to keep everything on the main menu animated some way or another as far as like marquees are concerned. Nintendo Switch. It is something that I'm working on as far as like emulation is concerned. Let's see here. So this is Yuzu. Just put on like a little Mario Odyssey and stuff like that, but it still works, but kind of interesting. A little bit bugged here and there. So instead of using the controls, I just use the analog sticks. But definitely need some work. not playable yet, but it's getting there. There's a few games that are playable, but just wanted to show some of the higher end emulators. There's some PlayStation 3. So the PlayStation 3 is looking a lot better. So if I go to something like I get this thing set up with the DualShock. The way it's supposed to be. There we go. Pretty quick to load. Our PCS3. And this runs a lot better than the Switch emulators and stuff. So there's a good percentage of games that are working pretty well on the PCS3 emulator. Let me get out of that. Close that out. So for the most part, shut off this controller here. Yeah. Xboxes, your TurboGrafx 16. Everything's steamed in some manner or way. Jaguars, Ataris. So for all these systems, except for the higher end stuff that requires lots of analog sticks, I've got the control panel all set up for everything. And I've also have my cabinet O controllers here. That has your Sega Genesis, Saturn, N64, Super Nintendo, Nintendo, Dreamcast, GameCube, and PlayStation. Controllers all built into one here. So this will highlight your joysticks in the manner they are. Still got the glow, except for it's not right in front of you. So basically, in the themes, I shut off, when you're in game, I shut off the strips that are right in front of you so you have the layering of it. And you can see your game. But when I go back to the main menu, these will turn back on again. Pretty much all the emulators are set up with scan lines. So you can see the scan lines are all set up to try to mimic a CRT in one way or another. I can go come over here and grab out a controller at any time. Any system I'm on, so the Sega controller here. Just plug it in. And detects automatically the controls are where they're supposed to be. Or I can still play on the control panel itself. So, you know, obviously it's more fun to play than an actual patrol. I could throw another controller on the other side for two-player games and stuff. Before I make this video too long, I'll throw on some other stuff here. Want to exit out. Now the ships come back on. Maybe Dreamcast. Some crazy taxi with maybe an original controller. That always works nice.
Hey, hey, come on over, have some fun with crazy taxi.
Sit here and I can go to this is a real Dreamcast troll. Everything's working okay. You know, I just plug it in and apparently I have to start the emulator with this controller plugged in or else it doesn't detect, but that's fine. Otherwise it just works on the control panel. That's what I originally had a problem. Now these don't all stutter like this. I think this is just this one right here. I usually don't have any problem with Dreamcast. I think once it actually warms up and everything's loaded in memory, it will stop stuttering. I could just as easily just use the control panel. Try. And another shot. But, so, let me finish off going through here. Here's all your console stuff. I can back out to the main menu again. Maybe go to PC-based games. This is all your Steam stuff, GOG stuff. Maybe you have some PC games in here. Steam stuff. Fighting games. These are like fighters and stuff like that. BlazBlues. Looking here. And all the controls are set up. This is Streets of Rage 4, just came out. All the control panels set up with it. Mortal Kombat, MK11, with the expansion, the Street Fighters, Street Fighter V, Championship Edition. Killer Instinct. Marvel's Capcom 3, Injustice. the PC. I don't really use any of this stuff. Maybe just there are other emulators and stuff like that. Maybe stick around with the Techno Parrot stuff. Pretty cool. Darius Burst. Widescreen.
Pause it through the loading.
And this one has a, since it's a widescreen, it's got a nice bezel that fits everything. Yeah. So it's got a four player setup. This video is getting pretty long, but maybe I'll go through the themes, which are kind of cool. 3DS, DS, some animated stuff. Same thing. Well, if anybody has any questions, just let me know. I think the video is long enough. I appreciate it. Thank you. Bye.